Okay, this is the Getting Started with Acoustic Measurements tutorial. If you want to know how to handle NVH measurements in a professional way, then this is the right place. My name is Till Palmfuß. I'm an acoustic engineer who saw a lot, and now I'm here to share my knowledge with you. As an easy startup example, I made sound and vibration measurements on this lawnmower. From the beginning, from the pure time data to the final acoustic measurement result, I show you step by step how to get there. For that, I use ArtemiS Suite, which is definitely my favorite software for NVH task. So if you have ArtemiS Suite and want to know how to work with the program, this tutorial is perfect for you, but also for all those of you who just want to know how to deal with acoustic measurement, this is a general tool. Oh, you can download all these measurement data for free. Just look in the description box, there's a download link, so you can follow me step by step, even if you're at home on your desktop. In this first clip, you will learn how to create a project, how to select the NVH measurements, how to choose and adjust some acoustic analysis, and of course, how to display your analysis results. The next videos will show you more and more advanced tools and features in ArtemiS Suite. So following the full series of clips, you get from zero to be a hero. Enjoy. Okay, start with the analysis. I use ArtemiS Suite 10 and will come up with the start page. Well, there are different tools to work with your data, but for the start, the best thing is the pool project. If your screen does not look like mine because some of the windows are already closed or something is just strange different, you can always go back to your default setting. Just click here on standard and you got the same start point like I do, okay? In the pool project, you can do almost everything. So it's really powerful tool and easy to use. That's why I like it. First of all, we feed the data, our measurements to the project. And so we browse in the navigator on the left. So my recordings are on the measurement data and there are lawnmower, there's a folder. And in this folder, I organize during the recordings, different subfolders. So one step back, what have I done? Well, on this lawnmower, there was this complaint that it is too loud, has this booming noise. And if you touch it, you feel a lot of vibration in the handle. So what to do? Well, for the acoustic, I just put on my binaural headset, so I have left and right ear just at the spot where you are when you use the lawnmower, so it's the right feeling. For the vibration, I used a triaxial accelerometer on the handle, X, Y, and Z direction. You get all the vibration, what you feel in one hand. Then I connected both sensors with my Quadriga 2, press record, and I was able to measure outside the acoustic and the vibration of the lawnmower in the place. The advantage of this example is a lawnmower can only be switched on and off. So that's only one RPM speed, one condition. But actually, there are more than just one condition. There are three. Because this lawnmower can have a trap basket behind. So all the green is catched in the basket. You can bring it anywhere else. On the other side, you can have a side throw. So the hole is not in the back, the hole is on the side. So for big areas, this is what you need. And then the third option, it's called mulching. So everything is closed down or holds down and the green is cut in really small pieces. So let's see what the effect is. And there is more. You can also have seven different cut heights on this lawnmower. You will not measure seven cut heights. This will be too much work for you. Make it simple, go through the extremes. We will measure on cut height one, the lowest. In the middle, cut height 4, and the highest is cut height 7, okay? And we see the effect of the cut height on the acoustics, and then we can just interpolate in between. So what I did is I just pressed record and start the engine of the lawnmower, measure 10 seconds and stop. And for safety reasons, I did every condition 3 times, so 3 records for each condition. Hold on, how many do we have now? Okay, we have 3 setups for catching the green. Multiply with 3 cut heights, this is 9 conditions, 3 times each condition, so we have 27 records to analyze. Well, that's a lot, it's a challenge. To jump now for the analysis, you can download these files to follow me on this track. So here, for example, is the situation side throw, and there are the recordings with the cut height 1, 3, 1, and cut height 4, for example, are here, with cut height 4, all these throws up here. So how I bring these into my project? Well, as easy as it can be, I just take the full main folder and just drag drop it to my project, and there it is. So from now on, I have access to my measurement data. And I call it just the access. You didn't copy anything. You don't create extra folders or extra data. You just have a link on your data. So whatever you do in your project will never affect your measurement data. There's no way you can destroy or disturb anything on your measurement. This stays safe, okay? It's just a link to your data. That's why a lot of people can work with the same data without interference, okay? Here, you can still sort the data in the order you like to have. For example, if I don't like to have basket cut in the beginning, I just mark these ones and place it anywhere else. If I put it on top, for example, it will be placed at the latest at the bottom of this line, okay? So mulching, side cut, and basket, these are my setups I like to have. If I watch inside, I can open, I can still see the same structure like it is on my data drive. So robust, well, it's the name of my lawnmower. We have this condition cut height 1 and the setup was mulching. Repetition 1, 2, and 3. And all these measurements are about 10 seconds. Yeah, okay. You can always like see here. Here are the next ones mulching. So everything is here to be ordered. I can even open each of the recordings and see what is inside. And here I can see we have left and right ear. And additionally, we have the handle. For the first test, I just choose this record here. And now we go this record to the next step. That will be what kind of analysis I like to use on these pure time data. Well, you as a starter, you're thinking about the sound pressure level. How loud is it? Yeah? So let's see how we insert this here. Right mouse click, or you can also press the insert key. Gives you the list of all the analyses which are available in ArtemiS Suite. Well, there's a lot, more than you need now, okay? Maybe you ever need in your lifetime, but you know what you want. So just type it in. I just type in level, and there's a list of all the level analyses which are available. And here we choose level versus time, which is the easiest one. Okay, but you can add more than just one analysis. If I press insert, I can also add maybe something with frequency, because we also want to know which frequency, which hertz frequency are dominant in our noise of the lawnmower. So the common one is FFT, fast Fourier transformation. And as long as this is a constant signal, the lawnmower, we take the average one. This is easy, okay? Well, for those of you who really want to know how loud this lawnmower appears for a human being, and not just a physical energy, I recommend to also insert the loudness analysis. So this is loudness versus time. Now we have the three analyses, and there are some parameters you can change for your measurements if you like. I show you where it works. Just click on the analysis, and all the settings which are available and can be changed are here on the right side. This is the property page. In the analysis here, I can see, for example, spectral weighting is set to none as a default. I think the world likes A weighting. This is a frequency weighting which is very, very common. It's not my favorite, but it's very, very common. So if you choose one, nobody will ask why. Yeah. So starter, take A weighting. Okay. The next one will be FFT average. So click on that one. I can hear all the settings for the FFT average setup. And here also spectral weighting can be set to A weighting. Okay. And loudness doesn't need this weighting stuff because there's everything always right. That's a good advantage of that one. Now we've got all these analysis results. The question is what to do with that. There are different destinations. Right mouse click, insert. Maybe you want to put it in Excel file for some statistic reasons. Maybe you want to calculate another project with that. This is too advanced now, you should forget that one. Maybe you want to analyze and hear what's going on, understand what's going on. That will be the mark analyzer. Or you just want to place it in PowerPoint report. That will be a report. Or you just want to compare different total values. For example, all these settings can be set up here. I, for the start, recommend the data viewer. It's normal. Just want to look at my results and see, is everything okay? Yeah. So the data viewer will be the first choice. Now, the setup is done. I choose one setup, mulching cut height 1, and I take all the 5 channels which are in there, so it's sound pressure and vibration. I pick 3 analyses, and this should be just in a data viewer. And then I press just calculate, and the data view is calculated. And there it goes. Here on top, you're seeing here still your pool project, and here's a new tab with the data viewer, okay? Well, and there is a lot. What I can see here on top is the level versus time analysis. Here is your FFT, that you can see there's a frequency axis. And here there is the zone, so the loudness of the noise, okay? This is locked here together. Well, here is the level of your microphones, and here is the level of your vibration signals here. So until this point, we select measurements, choose some acoustic analysis, and view these results in a data viewer. The next videos will be about how to trim the measurement, choose and separate special channels, and do statistic like averaging. You can follow this in YouTube by using the playlist function, or you just look in the description box. There are direct links to all of these videos of this Get Started tutorials. So, see you.